This week on Maker Update, the cyber deck who killed your character, wiggly robots, boxes without hinges, and hinges without hardware. Hello and welcome back to Maker Update, the show where we keep you up to date on all the cool things that makers are making. I'm Tyler Weingartner and I hope you're all doing great. We've got a super fun show for you, so let's get started with the project of the week. If you've ever played a tabletop role-playing game, you know at least two things. How delightful it is to get together with friends and engage in some communal storytelling, and how hard it is to get a game session together in the first place. What with coordinating schedules, getting someone to commit to being a GM, and getting everybody to agree on the game you're playing, which can be tough if your friends aren't into the game you want to play. James from the Sidavos Universe YouTube channel built a project to tackle this issue by building a cyber deck that works as an AI-powered virtual game master to run his own game of Cyberpunk 2020, created by Mike Pondsmith. He's using a NUC mini PC from Gigabyte in order to run the generative LLM that drives the game system. One of his goals was that the system should be completely portable. He wants to take the system on the road and he can power it with a power station battery. One of the coolest features of the design is that there's no need for a keyboard or mouse. It displays the text on the screen, but also reads it to you. And you interact with it by talking to it through this integrated microphone. He's enclosed everything in the 3D printed housing that furthers the cyberpunk aesthetic. From the mostly black body, the blood red detail pieces, and the neon green highlights. It's a good look, finishing everything off with braided cables for the monitor. And I love how you're still expected to manage your own character sheet and perform your own physical dice rolls.
Please roll a 1d10 and let me know the result.
Oh, it's an 8. I got an 8.
One of my favorite aspects of tabletop gaming is interacting with other people, and that's certainly not something that this can deliver. But there's something so satisfyingly dystopian about playing an RPG about the dark future of technology, with a console powered by what could be our next step into that world. That said, I've spent countless hours poring over tabletop role-playing game sourcebooks of games I never got to play because I never found the right group. And if projects like this would give you access to those games, then that's amazing. James offers everything you need to build one of these on your own. More projects. From Soy Boy Soft, we have this salamander walking bot that's a masterclass in soft robotics. The whole idea here is that instead of using motors to create actuation, you can use sealed bladders and pressure systems to create a 3D motion platform, similar to the way that the muscles in our own bodies work. The membrane is cast in silicone using a 3D printed mold. The actuation of each point is handled as a binary, which might seem limiting at first, but when you consider all four limbs have these 3 points of actuation, this offers a high fidelity range of motion, especially when you consider specific combinations and sequences of motion. But the whole project gets amplified through the introduction of microfluidics. This is the engineering process of using microchannels in structures to transfer fluid pressure, much in the same way as traces on a circuit board. This allows the robot to be more independent instead of being tethered to a control interface through a series of tubes. Jimmy DeResta has a video of how he made this New York City sewer cap with his own logo. The process begins with him carving a positive of his cast using his brand new Shapeoko CNC router. From there, the process involves making a mold using graphite and sand. This video covers the entire casting process from setting the sand, creating the channels, and the casting process itself. It's good stuff. If you're worried about the potential bombardment of the planet by asteroids, the Ruiz brothers have you covered with this asteroid tracker project. This is a small electronics project made from a QDPI S3, an iSpy BFF, and a circular 1.28-inch display. The code is set up to track the asteroid 2024 YR4, which until recently had a small chance of impacting the Earth. As is typical of their projects, the housing is entirely 3D printed and snaps together with minimal additional hardware. And finally, we have a new project by Chris Borga. This is a modular 3D printable fixturing system that functions around capturing bolts in this grid system. While it's somewhat dependent on your build plate size, he's developed some easy to print plates that can be extended through the use of bow ties. There's a whole ecosystem of clamps that you can use to keep steady whatever you need. Time for some tips and tools. We have a video from Darben Orvar on how to make 6 different boxes without any hardware for hinges or closures. From friction fits to sliding lids to wedge locks, this video is bound to inspire you with a ton of creative ideas on how to secure a box without any expensive hardware. Speaking of mechanisms that don't require any additional hardware, Slant3D has a video on how to create 3D printable hinges. Whether you want to create flexible, compliant hinges or print and place mechanical hinges, this video showcases a ton of different design options for various scenarios that you might need. Check it out. And finally, we have a fresh new episode of Gareth's Tips, Tools, and Shop Tales newsletter. And this one is full of bangers. There's a primer on tips you don't want to miss about tape measures, a comparison by Project Farm on adjustable wrenches, but maybe the most surprising tip here is how to safely dispose of toxic chemicals like paint by Dirt Farmer Jay. He compares traditional methods like cat litter and wood dust, plus a few commercial options designed for this exact purpose. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, we have a new video from Becky Stern, and it's all about the best connectors that you can use for your projects. Connectors can make your project easier to use and to work with, and the right connector can mean the difference between a dream and a headache. JST, TRS, alligator clips, terminal blocks, her list is exhaustive, but it's likely to introduce you to a few options you hadn't considered. All right, and that is going to do it for this week's show. A reminder, as always, you can get more info about every single one of these projects by following the links down in the description. While you're there, leave us a comment, give us a thumbs up, and hit subscribe so you don't miss the next one. Huge thanks, as always, to DigiKey for making this show possible and to you for watching. Take care. We'll see you soon.